Oregon EMS Data System Analytical Reporting Training, Transactional Reports. In this session, we'll access Oregon's ImageTrend Elite EMS Data System. We'll run a predefined report, modify that report, and create our own transactional report. This will be a hands-on practice session. We encourage you to log into the system using your own user ID and password so you'll have access to your own agency's data. You can shrink this video into one corner of your screen so that you can follow along as we build these reports. Log in to Oregon's ImageTrend Elite EMS data system by going to imagetrendelite.com/elite. The organization ID is Oregon. Please log in with your own username and password. Once you've logged in, go to the Tools menu and choose Report Writer. Let's run an existing predefined report in Report Writer. I'm interested in running a report that shows me my calls by day of week. I can use the search box to find that report. Here it is in the Call Information folder. It's called Runs by Day of Week. Let's click on that and run it. When we click on it, it brings up the definition of this report. To go ahead and run it as is, we can click Generate Report. This report has been designed to ask for several criteria for filtering. I'm going to leave all of the criteria blank and go ahead and run the report, which I can do by scrolling down to the bottom and clicking Generate. Now I have the results of my report. It shows the days of the week and how many runs we've had each day. Now let's modify this existing report. Let's say this is almost what we want, but there's a little bit of additional information that we would like to have on this report. We can modify the report by using the tabs across the top. Let's start with columns. So far, this report is including the incident day name, Sunday through Saturday, the number of runs, and the percent of total runs. Let's say we're also interested in the average response time for each day, to see if there's certain days where our response time is shorter or longer than other days of the week. Well, we can add a column to this report, and we can use the search box again to find the column that we want. So we want response time, which would be the amount of time it took from the time that the unit was notified by dispatch to the time that the unit arrived on scene. So we can search for some of that information. Let's say unit notified by dispatch. And we see there's lots of data elements that fit that search. Let's look through and find the one we want. It's right down here, unit notified by dispatch to unit arrived on scene in minutes. Now, if we were to simply include that column in our report, it wouldn't quite work the way we want it to, because we actually want to see an average across multiple records for that response time. So instead of directly including that element in our report, we need to create a column, which we can do with the Create Column button at the bottom. We're looking for an average, and the name of the field we can make up, so I'm going to call it Average Response Time. Let's find the column that we're looking for. Here it is, unit notified by dispatch to unit arrived on scene in minutes. And we can click Add. Now our report has the three existing columns that it already had, plus our new column that we just created for average response time. Let's go ahead and generate our report now. I'll leave all the filters empty and click Generate. We now have a report with the days of the week, the number of runs, percent of total, and this new column that we added for average response time. And here we can see that our response time varies quite a bit by day of week. What if I want to run this report again in the future? Well, do I have to come back to the runs by day of week report, make my modification every time and run it again? No, I can save the changes that I made into a My Reports folder. That way, when I come back to do this next week or next month, I can just run the report as I've already designed it. To save the modifications that we made to this report, go to the Actions tab and choose Save As. You can give your report a name. You can add a description if you'd like, and you can decide what folder to put it in. We'll go ahead and keep it in the Call Information folder and click Save. Now if I look on my menu on the left-hand side, I have a Runs by Day of Week with Response Time report in the Call Information folder of My Reports. So if I search now for Day of Week, I see that there are two reports. One is the original report that I ran at the beginning of this session, and it remains unchanged. It was created system-wide and is the same for everybody. This other one in the My Reports section is the report with the modifications that I made, the one that's showing on the screen here. And now I can come back in the future and run my report, or my version of that report. Next, let's create a transactional report from scratch. To create your own transactional report, we recommend taking the following steps. First, what's the question that you want to answer? Second, is there an existing report that answers the question, perhaps with some modification? If so, you can start with that report and make your changes. If not, you can create your own transactional report from scratch. Third, what are the columns that you want to display on your report? Fourth, how do you want to display them? Fifth, how do you want to group the information? Sixth, how do you want it sorted? And seven, is there any criteria that you want to apply to your report? Let's walk through these steps together and build our own report. To create a new report, click the Create a Report button. We're going to create a transactional report from EMS Incidence, so click EMS Incidence. So we're ready to create a report, but what's the question that we want to answer? For this example, let's say that we want to build a timeliness report, a report that will tell us how quickly our crew members are completing their patient care reports after the incident. Is there an existing report that already gives us this information? Well, for this example, we're going to pretend there's not, so we'll start from scratch. The third thing we need to ask ourselves is, what are the columns that we want in our report? Well, we need to know the user who created a patient care report, how long it took from the time the call happened to the time that they created the report, and we probably want that as an average. And then we might want to know how many patient care reports that user has created. So let's find the first column, the user who created the report. I'll search for created by, and I can see incident record created by as an option. I'll go ahead and select that. Next, we want the time from unit notified by dispatch till the record was created in the system. But again, we want an average for that time. So just like we did with the last report, we need to create a column to give us the average. So I click Create Column. We're going to use Average. We're going to call it Timeliness. And we're going to search for the column that we need. So as I search here, I see unit notified by dispatch to record created in hours. How many hours it took from the time the call started to the time that the patient care report was begun. I'll choose that and click Add. Now there was one more column we wanted, which was just a count of the number of patient care reports that that user has created. We'll need to create column again for that. And instead of an average, we'll choose a count. We'll give it a name and click Add. For this report, we don't need to define any special display options, grouping, sorting. Maybe we want to apply some criteria, so let's go to the criteria page. And let's say we want to allow the person running this report to apply a filter to the report. And let's say we're interested in using incident unit notified by dispatch date time as a potential filter. So we can select that. Now we're ready to run our report. So we can click Generate Report. Because we set up a filter, it's going to ask us to filter our results by unit notified by dispatch date time. We can leave it blank, or we could choose, for example, that it is equal to this month, or this year, this quarter, or put in a date range. I'm going to leave it blank for now and click Generate. Now I have my timeliness report. On the left-hand side, I see the user IDs of various users who have created reports in my agency. On the far right, I see how many patient care reports each user has created. And in the timeliness column, I see the average number of hours that it has taken from the time that the incident started to the time that the EMT started their patient care report. If I'd like to be able to run this report again in the future, I can save it. So I'll go to the Actions tab and click Save. I'll give it a name and choose a report folder. I can share this report with other users if I'd like to, and then click Save. My new report now shows up in a new folder in the My Reports section of the report writer. I can come back later and run that report again. Report Writer has a couple additional features that you might be interested in. They're available from the Actions menu. One is Export. So I can export this report, for example, in CSV format, so that I can load it into a spreadsheet like Microsoft Excel. Also, I can schedule this report. If I choose that option, I can create a schedule, and this report will be emailed to me on a regular basis according to that schedule. Of course, you want to make sure that if you schedule any reports, that those reports don't contain confidential information, because that should not be sent by email. Staff at the Oregon Health Authority would be happy to help you with building your analytical reports to get the most out of your Oregon EMS data system. You can contact Oregon Health Authority staff using the email addresses or phone numbers shown on this screen. You can also visit the ImageTrend University site for additional training information.